I'm about to attempt to disassemble a Mac Mini from August of 2011. Some people call this the mid-2011. Some people call this the late 2011. To the best of the ability of this iPhone I'm using to make this video on, I'll try to show you. It came with line. It shipped with line. See, the focus is not that good on the iPhone, but it says Intel Core i5, because I can see it's kind of blurry coming through here. And if anyone can read it, I'll just even give you a quick glimpse of all these specifications. Looks like model number A1347. And here, this is to give you an idea that it's one of the ones that had these little kind of countersunk holes in it to assist in taking it loose. And this little dot, you just basically move the dot here from the dot here to the dot here on the alignments. You take it from being lined up with this one to being lined up with this one. And then all of this mechanism, combination of this, this, and probably this, holds it on. And there's some kind of little gasket type of thing, I believe it was glued around here, just kind of following around the middle. Before I ever opened this thing up, I decided it started running rather hot. It would heat up rather quickly, and I don't know, it seemed like I could get maybe 2 or 3 hours use out of it, and before I could just run it all the time. So I took that gasket off after taking this back plate off and just studying this fan. I concluded that the amount of air this fan could move left it a little bit better suited to cool without this gasket, where it's just, and I don't even remember, it seems like that the air is pulled in, that it passes, it was designed to pass a small amount through and out some of these holes. And again, you're not seeing the newest Mac Mini, probably out through here, by the way, on the air, but these connections are from 2011. And in another video I may show you, I may wind up disassembling one from mid to late 2014. And I'm trying to remember now, it seems like I had disassembled this. I believe I left these loose. Well, they are loose now for sure. Two of these are loose. It seems like that the fan was the first thing to take loose. This may not be the absolute best way to disassemble one of these. In fact, these screwdrivers I'm using, they're just kind of vaguely identified as precision screwdrivers. I bought them in early 2007. I don't even remember which one. Well, this one I used, and it definitely allowed me to go ahead and pop the backing plate off once I twisted it. It lined up the dots, lined up one dot to another. But I remember I got a little bit farther along in here. But this time, what I'm going to try to do is disassemble it until I can access the power supply. And I have some Allen wrenches. I'm looking here. I may have to start a different video altogether. It seems like that rather than try and find the exact key, the exact size Allen wrench, well, there's a trick or two that sometimes works, which I may be showing you for taking these screws off. And maybe even these two. I can tell right now these two, if I have to dig down in here, that's going to require digging for Allen wrenches and what have you. Every once in a while you can luck out and you can get something like a Phillips head screw. And this is a crude way of doing it. It's not meant to work that way, but every once in a while you can just kind of jab one of these down into something like this and it'll turn. And I'm not saying it with respect to Mac Minis, I'm just kind of saying it when you run across things like this. If you're not going to be taking it loose all the time, and if you're not going to be applying an awful lot of torque to it, and if you're wanting to risk rounding something, you might be able to get it to come loose. I've disassembled and reassembled various things in my lifetime, mostly larger items than this, automotive items. But I got a general idea how much torque is too much to apply if I'm worried about rounding something off. And again, I'm just using my fingers to take this loose. And I'm wondering now, I can tell already this is not going the way I remembered, because two little rubber seals have come loose. And I do not remember them being on here. So now, I'm going to have to pull this aside for a moment so I can get a little bit closer look. Okay, I'm going to come back to this after I've studied what tool I'm going to wind up needing to take this loose, because it doesn't look... Those rubber seals, which I pulled, had me thinking that they looked to me like they were just solid metal heads and therefore going to take a little bit larger screw in there, and for that matter, that my turning on with my fingers was going to be sufficient to take this thing loose the way I did before. So, I will be back with you in a moment. And hopefully this will go a lot smoother.